What do you say? It's unreal. It is. But we're going to show up like we always do. And we'll chat about it.
The first time in 45 years that a team has been in the eight. I mean, for all rounds. Let that sink in. Just let that sink in. 45 years. That's as rare as rocking horse shit. Just happens to us all the fucking time, Terry. All the time. It's always us. We're always the meme. We're always the laughing stock.
What happened was bound to happen. You know, it was. This was indicative of our entire season.
I think that Geelong would prepare themselves this way and allow the kind of culture that we have where sloppy is kind of okay. You know, if we get a win, yeah, it's still kind of okay. No, you have to breed that out of the club. You know, the culture exists for a long time, you know, unless you willfully and actively try and change it. And that's what it seems like we haven't done. We've got the obvious talent. You know, we've got a great list. There's still, you know, a few holes, but we've got a great list. But I tell you what, you know, around the edges, we're not good enough in the end. And, you know, and that is from the coach down. You know, maybe that's too negative, but I just feel like if we want to get to the spot where we all want to get to, we just can't accept this mediocrity anymore. And, you know, I don't know how we manage it in dialogue, you know, to keep positive, but at the same time, there has to be like this steely resolve underneath what we say.
You know, they missed the chances early in the fourth quarter, and then it was just, you could just see it, they just waltzing through the middle of the ground. It was just same old things again and again.
We're on the right track. No doubt, but there's
got to
be a circuit breaker somewhere.
If I say to you we're going to lose a point to Collingwood and miss out on finals by 0.5%, right? You'd go, no, you could have anything on that and that would never have happened.
Yeah.
Because finals was on the agenda last year.
Yes.
And the year before. That's why the changes were made to senior coaches and so on and so forth.
But I think the year is definitely a failure.
Has to be now.
I don't think you can view it any other way, to be honest. And if you do view this year as a success, then this cycle will just continue.
Exactly.
But where's the maturity to just take 30? Just take 30, please, and just keep that goal. That's over. Game over.
That's the beauty about footy, but like, man, like this. I tell you what, like 20 years of my life, it's been. You know, it's been up and down with all the footy, but like this year was the best like footy to watch. Like you went to every game and it's like we had a chance to win. And that hasn't been, you know, it hasn't been like that ever, really, in my time. Besides,
we're in denial, we're reactive and we're predictable.
I get it, but we have to live with that. Like the next 6 months, we're dealing with this shit. And I know they hurt. Can't say that they don't care. But they get paid to do that.
Correct.
We don't get paid.
And people will say that we lost the lid too early and that we were too over the top. But that's life. You've got to live in the moment because of this moment right now, because you never know when it will be taken away.
I just can't like because that season's over. That season's over and it shouldn't be. We were 8-2 and 10-4, mate. We're chokers. Come on. We're just chokers.
I don't think we're going to be... It's about bringing players in. It's just about, you know, getting them to believe and get better in those crunch times and improving their mental psyche. I mean...